Me con Jericho, I'm going now live. Go. Just confirm that you all are getting my screen properly.
Yeah.
Perfect. Thank you. Thank you for the acknowledgement, guys. Okay. So again, good morning, good afternoon, and good evening, wherever you all are. Welcome. Welcome to Coinic Solution. And here in this webinar, we are going to discuss about the cloud security steps. Let me just make the net full there. Yep, thank you. Okay, so today's agenda is actually to discuss on certificate of cloud security knowledge. You know, the cloud is one of the very popular technology today. And most of the organization is actually moving towards the cloud there, or already have been moved towards the cloud there. But one of the major concern for all of these organizations, or who had already been moved to the cloud, or who is willing to move into the cloud there, is actually to understand and to check how exactly the security things will work for them. Certificate of cloud security knowledge is actually letting them know how exactly the security will work on the cloud. In the cloud, we are very much relying on the shared responsibility model. So we are always having a reliance on the cloud provider. So cloud consumer is definitely having some of the responsibility. Now, how much that responsibility is, it totally depends on the kind of service model you are using. But one of the major concern of most of the consumer is how exactly the security things will work. And if I'm handling the security as a consumer, then how exactly this security configuration I have to do. Certificate of cloud security knowledge is actually going to provide you the, you know, the pillars to understand all of these things properly. And then after, you can move towards the advanced level of security. Definitely when we are moving towards the security, one of the major concern for most of the organization is how exactly the compliance is also work there. And for that, what are the different set of regulatory or industrial requirement I have to fulfill? This course is actually discussing about all of these stuffs. So it is going to start with what exactly the cloud from the security point of view. Then what are the different roles and responsibility, and how exactly these responsibility will affect the security stuffs. And specifically, if we are comparing with our traditional infrastructure, what are the core difference between them? And definitely, what are the similarities them? And then based on that, we will be discussing about how exactly we can configure the security according to the industry best practices. And definitely, we are making our organization compliant as per the security requirement. So CCSK. Now, Certificate of Cloud Security Knowledge is actually from Cloud Security Alliance, which is one of the organization which is continuously giving the best practices and standard for the cloud security. For that, you need to understand different level and different type of components which is there in the cloud. And based on that, security configuration definitely needs to, you know, define there. So our discussion is actually going to be on that here. So I'm going to let you know what exactly this course is all about. Then after, the content of this course, like what are the core things we are going to discuss in this certification course. And then after, how exactly you will be earning that certification. For Coinic Solution, the passing rate for our students is 100%, specifically for the CCSK certification course there. So definitely the certification you can achieve very easily there. Definitely, it is like how exactly the things you will be grabbing it. Another thing is, and very importantly, is actually the knowledge, because it is going to help you understand the compliance and the security requirement, and it will help you to implement the things properly when you are going to work in the organizations. So our training and our consulting is actually going to be in a way so you can understand the best practices and the core security solutions which is there onto the cloud. Sometimes we don't have the solutions which is actually offered by the cloud provider, but definitely for that, what are the different options we have? That one too, we are going to discuss here. So our discussion point is actually going to be there on the, it's overall going to divide it into three. First is the introduction. Second, the core content. Third is actually about the examination. And then after, we will be discussing about, you know, I will be actually taking some of your questions, which is, you know, definitely you, after the our discussion, definitely you should have some questions in your mind there. You wanted to understand the security solutions and might be the next options there in your career. So that things we are going to take up there. With me, there is one more we have from our organization, that is Shadri. He's also going to introduce himself there. But before that, let me introduce myself. My name is Rajiv Kumar, and I'm the full-time consultant and security trainer for Koinix Solutions. I'm having various different certification in the security world. The first thing, I'm almost having more than 14 plus year of experience there in the cloud security and the information and security. I had acquired over the time very many different certification, like certified certified in information system security. I'm also cloud security professional there. I'm also information security manager. I'm already certified in CISC as well, and I'm also chief information security officer there. Having different trainer certification as well, like I'm a Microsoft certified trainer, I'm EC Council's instructor, and definitely I'm having the CCSK and CCSK plus certification as well there from the Cloud Security Alliance. Apart from that, having some more certification, specifically if I'm going to learn the relevant certification, I'm having certification from Azure, I'm having certification from AWS, and definitely from the GCP as well there. So these are, this is what I am there. This is what exactly I'm going to discuss from this particular side there. So yeah, this is what I'm. With me, Sushadri is also there from my organization. So Sushadri, if you take some time and introduce yourself in the panel there. So after that, I'm going to start my discussion here. Thank you.
Thank you, Raju. Thank you so much. Good morning, everyone, guys. I hope I'm audible to everyone. Anyone yes. can confirm?
Yes, okay, you are.
Thank you. Thank you so much. Guys, I'm Sushadri. I look into the ILO operations and quality and training assessment in Koinix Solutions. Before we could start up the session, the webinar, just wanted to introduce a little bit about our Koinix, our organization, and the offerings what we offer. So basically, Koinix, it has been started more than 25 years old company, and we are into this industry more than 25 years, and we are known for, you know, onshore and offshore training in IT training company. So we have more than 7 branches in India, and as well as we are operational in Australia, Sydney, you know, and London, and various part of the world. So we do deal with 1,000 plus certification courses, and as well as more than 30 partnership we are holding, majorly like Microsoft, VMware, Azure, VMware, Red Hat, and all. So if anyone has any requirements related to any IT courses or project management courses, e-courses, if you have the requirement, by the end of the session, you can let us know, or like I have dropped my email ID and the contact details in the chat window. Anyone can ping me. I will be available in the chat, and even the website address, I will give it to you. And we are also known for the, you know, customized courses as well. If anyone has, any corporate or like any client has a requirement, where multiple technologies are involved, multiple domains are involved. So according to the client's need, we can customize the product and we can deliver that as well. Okay. So if anyone has any kind of course queries, or like, you know, if anyone you know, not sure like which will be the suitable course for me, you know, what is the scope of that course, even in such a case, you can let us know. We can, you know, organize the call from our technical team, from our, you know, very expertized and experienced trainers who can guide you, who can assist you in choosing the right course, you know, and the career path for you. If you have any questions, I will be available in the chat. You can ping me. I'll be assisting you on that. Thank you so much, everyone. Rajiv, over to you.
Yep. Thank you. Thank you, Seshadri. Okay, guys. After this short introduction from Seshadri, now let me, start from where I left there. So as I told you that this certification course, Certificate of Cloud Security Knowledge, is actually going to help you understand different aspects of cloud security. Okay. Now, when we are discussing about the cloud security, there are so many things we have in the cloud there. Okay. We have different type of cloud certifications there in the market, right? Like when you are going for the certification in the market, you might be taking the vendor specific certification, like you will be taking the Azure certification there. Like when you're going for the Azure, you will be having Azure Fundamental, like AZ-900. Then you are going to take the AZ-103 or 104, which is actually for the administration. Then you will be going for the 300, which is actually for the architect. And then you are going for the 500, which is actually for the security. The similar thing we have even for the AWS as well. AWS is one of the leading vendor, which is actually leading right now the market for the cloud stuffs there. So whenever you're looking for the cloud solution, definitely you are going for the some of the well-known vendor report there. One of the leading, you can say the vendor which is actually providing the proper reporting about like which product and the solution is actually best in the market, you might be looking for the Gartner's report there. And according to Gartner's report, AWS right now is leading the market there. And after that, we have Azure, Microsoft Azure. And after Microsoft Azure, we have the Google. So AWS, Microsoft Azure, and the Google, that these are actually the three top providers which are there in the market there, which is right now leading the market there. So whenever you're looking for the cloud solution, you might be looking for the AWS or Azure. Now, it totally depends like what is actually flexible for you there. Definitely based on that, you will be taking that particular solution there. I will be taking all of your questions, guys. Just give me a few minutes to let me complete this particular section, and definitely I will be taking all of your questions one by one there. Thank you for that, and thank you for your patience as well. So as I told you that we have different type of vendor specific certification. Okay, but this time I'm not talking about a vendor certification, specific certificate here. This time I'm actually introducing here for you is actually the vendor neutral certification. So whether you are using Microsoft Azure, whether you are using AWS, or you are using Google as a provider there, as your cloud provider there, no matter which provider you are using, one of the common requirement for each of the solution which you are right now using is how exactly the security will work there. See, the thing is, if I'm looking for a product, if I'm looking to process my information with the help of product offered by the Microsoft or might be the AWS or might be the Google, the thing is how exactly the security for my information will work there. If I'm sending my informations to third party, like my cloud provider, how exactly the cloud provider will take care of the security of my solutions there? You can say for the information there. So like if I'm sharing my information to them, isn't my information is protected with them? You know, sometime even the cloud provider is also going to create a risk for you. And definitely when you're going for the cloud is actually a multi-tenant environment. When you say multi-tenant environment, it means multiple different consumers group is actually utilizing the cloud. And when different set of consumers are utilizing the same platform, one of the core issue is if proper isolation is not there, if proper segregation is not there, then the possibility is there that informations can compromise very easily from there. So what we have to first understand in the cloud, what are the basic structure of the cloud? And that basic structure is really good for me or not, you know, security wise. And if there is any loophole, what are the different controls offered by the provider to mitigate that issues there? You know, when you're going for any of the solution, you are actually looking, you have to measure the risk around the solution there. Risk is basically the probability where some event will simply going to disrupt all of the activity there. And definitely it is going to create a negative impact on the business there. So definitely when you are going for any of the product or the solution, you wanted to increase the, you know, benefit. You don't want it to go into the loss there. Perfect. So when you're going for the cloud is definitely is going to provide you the multi-tenant solution, but at the same time, with the help of proper isolation and with the help of proper segregation, and definitely for that, you require a proper virtualization architecture there. See, in the cloud, virtualization, isolation, segregation is totally going to taken care by the provider. And they have to give you the proper evidence that we are taking care of the infrastructure security properly for you. So if you are going to host your information on cloud infrastructure, which is actually managed by some third party, like in case of Microsoft Azure, it is definitely managed by the Microsoft. Then that time you are very much comfortable to share with them. Why? Because third party, trusted third party has attested that the control is working fine and it is effective as well. If control is there, but if it is not effective at the end of the day, it is not going to create a, you know, major impact for you there. So definitely you are going to look for a cloud provider, which is security wise good. And for that, third party attestation is going to play a very role, a very important role there. Now it totally depends on what kind of cloud service model you are using. Based on that, cloud security responsibility can vary. Like when you go for the cloud security model, you will be having three options there. So let me just use my proper, you know, ink there. So when I'm going for the cloud security solution, you will be having three options there. One is infrastructure as a service. The another is called as platform as a service. And the another is software as a service. When you go for the infrastructure as a service, most of the security responsibility or the control has been given there to the customer. It means customer is having control over in case of infrastructure as a service to manage the security properly. But in case of platform as a service, somehow it is balanced between customer and provider. But in case of SaaS, software as a service, now so remember, software as a service is one of the major solution. So out of, if I'm comparing all three of them, software as a service is actually utilized very much in the market there. Whether you're using a web browser, whether you're using an email server, you know, in that cases, you're actually utilizing the software as a service. And software as a service provided is mostly having the responsibility to secure it. So when you are utilizing the cloud, the first thing you have to understand which service model you are, you know, going to utilize there. And based on that service model, you have to understand what is your responsibility and what is the provider responsibility. See, if I'm not clear what is my responsibility, why while I'm protecting something, in that case I'm not very much aware about what are the things I have to do to implement the solution. Might be that solution offering is actually going to done by the provider, but if I'm not clear, definitely I cannot provide the security properly there. So this is the first thing you have to understand, who is responsible for what. And after that, you have to understand what are the different tools offered by the provider for you there. Like when you go for the infrastructure as a service, because most of the responsibility is onto the customer to implement it, definitely the infrastructure as a service provider will offer you the solutions. Now, when I'm saying solution, it means I'm actually talking about the controls. So most of the provider is actually going to offer you the control. All the customer have to do is to implement this control properly. Let's take an example. In infrastructure as a service, you are building a virtual machine. And for this virtual machine, you have to provide proper solution, or you can say the protection. So if I'm creating VM, the first thing I have to make sure that I'm implementing a strong password. So only the authorized user can access the VM. The second thing I have to implement is to configure a proper firewall, which is letting me only connect there. The third thing I have to implement is the encryption. So I can make sure only I can access the data because I'm having the authorized key there. Now see carefully. If these three options has been not offered by the provider, do you have any options to implement it there? Because see, what is happening here, I'm actually going to do everything on a third party infrastructure. If third party has not offered you these solutions, you cannot implement it. Why? Because there is no any options given there for the integration of your solutions onto the provider side. Now, most of the provider is offering you the APIs, application program interface, through which you can integrate your custom solution as well to offer the better control there. So when we are going for the cloud, first thing we have to understand what service model is actually going to suit my requirement. And definitely this selection totally depends on your business. So it is actually the business which definitely drives the solution selection. So when you go for the IaaS, PaaS or SaaS, it's basically the business requirement. It is the business which actually drives the selection of the solution there. Suppose you are looking to invest less and you wanted to gain more, SaaS is actually going to be the best solution for you there. But what exactly the problem with the SaaS is, because most of the things is going to manage by the provider. The problem here is because provider is managing most of the option. If I wanted to do some changes, or suppose I wanted to do some integration of my custom solution, the chances are very less that provider is going to offer you these options. So integration of your own control is actually going to be tough here in the SaaS there, or modification in the control there. But when you go for the IaaS, infrastructure as a service, where most of the security responsibility is actually on the customer, you know, there is a higher chance that you can integrate your custom solution there. It means if you require more control over the solutions, you have to go for the IaaS. But if you require less control, and definitely less price as well, because most of the things is going to manage by the provider, licensing, control configuration, you know, data center management, definitely the cost is going to be lesser there. So infrastructure is going to be, you know, provide you most of the options to implement the control properly. But in case of SaaS, it is actually going to manage by the provider. But I'm not saying that it's a, you know, one of the, you know, negative thing here. Because when you go for the SaaS, software as a service solution, that time, because most of the things is going to manage by the provider, it means they are managing your solutions properly. Definitely they are going to hire the experts which will manage your solution on behalf of you there. So you have to first check what exactly your current requirement is, business requirement is, and based on that you are going to select the solution. Now this CCSK certification course is actually going to let you know from that perspective, and definitely the target audience for this particular certification is the guys who's working in the professionals here. So if you are the cloud professional, This certification is actually going to best suits your requirement. Cloud architect. So when you're designing the solution, you have to most of the time do the cost and benefit analysis. And based on that, you have to select the solution as well. Definitely you have to do the risk measurement and risk management as well. Even that one, that time also, it is going, this certification course is actually going to help you. As a cloud administrator, you need to know the best practices to implement the solution. So if you do the CCSK, you are actually going to have a view from that point of view as well. Like what are the best practices available for the solutions to implement there. So cloud administrator is actually going to have knowledge from that particular point of view as well. As a cloud security engineer, even that one too is going to cover very properly there. Like what are the solutions available there? Like when I'm going for the SaaS, under the encryption, what are the different type of encryption solutions we have there and how can we implement? As a compliance officer, you also need to know what are the different compliance options we have there onto the cloud. Like on the cloud, we are definitely managing the data or the information properly. So for the data protection, what are the different options we have? The first thing, and then whether these solutions I can configure in my location. Like suppose in cloud, you will be getting a very good option there that is called the replication. So when you're going for the replication in the cloud, you can replicate your data from one location, you can say from one geographical location to another geographical location very fastly and very easily there. But according to some, you know, some regulations there, some law there, you might restricted to replicate the data to some another country or the geographical location there. So is it permittable from that particular law or not? That one also. So in for the compliance officer, they have to actually understand different perspective related to the data and related to the solution. This certification course is also going to help you know what are the best way to implement the solution and what are some of the, you know, cases happened previously which actually targeted the organizations to pay a huge amount of fine because of the non-compliant. So that one too, we will be understanding in the same certification course there. If you are an incident handler, even that certification course, this certification course is actually going to help you as well. No, if I'm saying incident handling, so in case of incident handling, we are actually going to manage incident there. But for the incident handling on the cloud, what are the different options given there? Is there any tool we have? Is there any security solutions we have? So definitely that one too is actually going to help you. Definitely, I will take your question there. Thank you. From the incident handling perspective, how exactly the incident will work on the cloud? And for the incident handling or for the incident detection, what are some of the tools given there? And what are the best way to handle the incident on the cloud? Even that one too, we will discuss here. Now, in case you are a network professional, even for you also having something here, because in the cloud, you have to design the whole network from the scratch there. Definitely this time you have the virtual network. It's not the physical network, but the virtual network. So when you're designing the virtual network, so you will be creating the VNets, virtual networks. And then after, you will be connecting your resources there with the cloud there. So when we are connecting the resources, what are the different network options we have? And how exactly this network or networking will actually work under the cloud there. So as a network professionals, we will see how exactly we can design the solutions there. And if you're a decision maker, definitely I'm talking this time about the CIO, CISO. So that time you must understand the solution properly before you are going to make a decision there. So for you as well, this certification course is actually going to help you very, very much, because this certification course is actually going to let you know the solutions from the higher level as well. So at least when you are selecting any of the service model or any of the, you know, deployment model, what are the benefits we have and what are the, you know, negative impacts it actually can generate for your organization. Even that one too, we'll discuss there. And definitely after understanding the pros and the cons of all of the solutions, you are going to refine the solution which is actually going to work best for your organization. Not only these target audience, definitely we have some more there, but these are some of the target audiences. Actually, some of them, definitely the CCSK certification course is going to best source the requirement. And after that, you know, the next level is also there. So in this certification course, we will be discussing for the same. The next question is, why CCSK? So as I told you, that when we are implementing the cloud solution, it's not only the solution. See, the thing is, right now in the market, it's very much required that our solutions can work in a network, so I can access it from any of the location, definitely. And we can implement the things, you know, more in a more feasible way as compared to the previous one. When you check the cloud attributes are actually going to source all of the business requirement very easily there. When you see the five different characters of the cloud, which you can actually measure it through a keyword that is called BRROM, BROM, which is broad network access. So B basically indicating broad network access. So when I'm implementing the cloud, I'm actually, you know, accessing the solutions broadly from there. So CCSK actually stands for Certificate of Cloud Security Knowledge there. Okay. So when I'm talking about the broad network access, it means a solution, I can access it from any of the location there. Why? Because the cloud is actually offering solutions to each part of the world. No matter where you are, all you require just the internet connection. And from that internet connection, you can connect with your solutions very easily there. The another options has been given there are, so R is actually for the rapid elasticity. It means you can actually increase or decrease the resources as per the requirement of the organization. You know, one of the major issue we are facing from the very, you know, long time in the traditional infrastructure, that our workload is actually not static. Sometime the number of customers which is connecting onto my website is 10 only, and sometime the number of customers which is connecting to my website is more than 10,000. In this case, I cannot allocate a resource because the requirement of the customers actually, or you can say the number of customers actually keep changing there. So what we have to understand here, because of this flexible nature of the business, we have to understand we require a flexible infrastructure as well. So as per the requirement, it will automatically increase and it will automatically decrease as well. Suppose you are, you know, based on your assumption of 10,000 customers, you had created your infrastructure with very many different resources there, but you are not getting that many of customers there. In that case, your resources are wasted there. Cloud is actually going to best source that particular model. If right now the number of customers are 10, I require only 2 GB of RAM. That is enough for me. But if the number of customers are 10,000, might be I require more than 128 GB of RAM there, or might be 1 TB of RAM there. So that rapid elasticity nature is actually available there into the cloud. And the best part is you are paying only for the resource which you're using. So if I'm paying on the number of RAM only for 1 hour, definitely I'm paying only for that much of time there. So the one of the major component we have is this M, which is actually called as the measured service there. So broad network access, rapid elasticity. And the another thing is, you know, resource pooling. You know, the providers are actually going to provide you the resources by pulling multiple hardwares together, by creating a single unit there. And that single unit is actually going to be available to you there. So for you, it is the unlimited number of resource, but definitely in the background, provider have to work very hard to make it available there. And the another thing is on-demand self-service. So whenever you require any resource, you can actually take that resource in a minute and you can start configuring that resource for you there. So these are the five different features of the cloud, which is actually given there by one of the recognized organization that is called the NIST. NIST, which is actually providing the, you know, different best practices and the guideline to implement in your organization there, specifically for the federal organizations. NIST is one of the recommended ones. So NIST, according to NIST, these are the five unique features of actually given there. There is a definition also there for the cloud, but again, that one we will discuss later. So why CCSK, why Certificate of Cloud Security Knowledge? First thing, it's a vendor neutral certification. So we are not going to concentrate on any of the vendor like Azure or AWS. Definitely each of them is having their own feature and own benefit there. So we are not going to concentrate on any of the vendor, but on these vendors, what are the core things you have to look for from the security perspective? Like, as an example, we can take encryption. Because we are sharing data to third party, encryption solution should have to be there in the cloud. Because if my data is not encrypted, not only other customers can access the data, but even the provider can also access your data there. And if in any of the cases, your data is actually get leaked, and if the data is going to be leaked, definitely it is going to create a major risk for your organization there. Not only reputation wise, but definitely financially is also going to create a major damage to them. So in this vendor neutral certification, we will be discussing about the core risk around the cloud solutions, whether you're using the software as a service, platform as a service, or infrastructure as a service. And then after, we will be discussing about the solutions under that particular risk. So when I'm talking about the data, you know, compromise or might be the data leakage, what are the different options offered by the different vendor? And then after, we will be discussing about, and then definitely we are going to check the best practices guideline given there by the security as a service documentations there. The another thing, definitely we will using the best practices there. Now best practices definitely going to created by after connecting multiple experts there, after seeing multiple case studies there, which is actually getting updated on a timely basis. But definitely for the current scenario, for the current timing, for the time being there, what are the best practices available for the cloud implementation? That one two we will be discussing in the Certificate of Cloud Security Knowledge there, which is definitely is going to provide a core level of security to your organization when they are going to implement the solutions within the organization there. We will be very much discussing about the security risk in the cloud there. So when we are moving our data onto the cloud, how exactly the security is getting impacted? What are the core differences between the traditional infrastructure and on the cloud, and how the security will differ there, and what are the different options and solutions we have there? Remember, most of the vendor solution which you're right now utilizing, like might be you're utilizing the Palo Alto firewall, might be you're utilizing the Checkpoint firewall, might be you're utilizing the Cisco IDS there. All of the solutions are available there in the cloud as well. So no matter, or it doesn't matter that which provider you're utilizing, each of the solutions which are right now you're utilizing in your traditional infrastructure is also available. So might be for you, Cisco Firepower is actually best solution there. So in that case, you can integrate the same solution in the cloud as well. So you're not dependent on the cloud vendor to select only that solution. You can implement any of the solution. All you have to just purchase the solution from the marketplace and implement it there. So first thing you need to understand the risk, because without understanding the risk, if you're implementing the solution, you're not so much clear how much benefit you are getting there. Suppose you are implementing a solution which is actually costing you $5,000. In that case, how can you say that that solution is actually giving you the benefit if you are not aware about what are you losing right now? So first thing you have to understand what are the different risks if the solution is not implemented properly. And based on that, the solution control, we are going to find it out. Definitely the CCSK certification is going to help you from that perspective as well. If you are an auditor, for the auditor, what are the different things they have to check while going for the auditing? Security best practices, implementation, you know, solutions implementation proper is there or not. Different things we have to check there. There are some documentations available, and one of the core documentation I can refer here is the CCM, Cloud Control Metrics, which is actually available in the version 3.01 there. So when you take this documentation, it is actually having all the different type set of controls given there. Definitely how to implement the control, that one is actually discussed in the guidance there. But this Excel document is actually provide you the proper core information about the different best practices, different regulations, which needs to be implemented based on the type of data you are managing. Remember, all of the control is actually not relevant for you there, because cloud is offering you n number of controls there. So which control suits when, that one you need to understand as well. CCSK is built in a way so you can understand which solution is going to be implemented when there. If you're a cloud customer, definitely this one is actually going to very much important for you, because as a cloud customer, you need to understand what are the different risks you have while you're moving into the cloud there. So if I'm a cloud customer, I have to understand what are the different type of issues can possible when I'm moving toward the cloud there. So CCSK is going to let you know there by, you know, discussing in the security risk. Best practices, definitely compliance understanding, and you know, measurement or for the risk as well. That one too, we are actually going to check it there. So these are some of the things which we have to check there. Okay. So we had already discussed there that who are the target audience there. Now I will be discussing on the course content. So when you're going to take this certification, CCSK, Certificate of Cloud Security Knowledge, first thing in the CCSK, which this certification course is actually from CSA, Cloud Security Alliance. So this certification is actually from Cloud Security Alliance, which is one of the vendor. And CSA is offering you two certification. One is CCSK, Certificate of Cloud Security Knowledge, and another is CCSK Plus. The difference between them is CCSK is actually going to let you know about all of the things which I had till now discussed with these, all of the different topics which is listed in this slide. But that one is actually going to be completely fundamental and theoretical based there. But when you go for the CCSK Plus, this is actually going to let you know from the practical point of view as well. It means when I'm going for the implementation of the solution, how exactly these solutions will work there. But CCSK Plus is actually for those guys who's already working on the cloud infrastructure. So I can remove some of the, you know, position from this particular name there. Like suppose you are just, you know, the high level, like suppose you are not a implementer, you're just a decision maker. I will be not recommending the CCSK Plus for you there. Because for you are not going to implement the solution. You just need to know about what are the best practices available, how exactly these things will work there. So these are the two different certifications. So this is actually going to be with lab, and this is actually going to include it with theoretical stuffs there. And definitely here we are going to discuss more about the cases there. And these cases we are going to implement in the lab solutions there. So when you go for the CCSK, or CCSK Plus, the contents are going to be same. The only difference is actually going to be with CCSK Plus is going to include it with lab, and CCSK is going to be completely theoretical, and definitely the best practices we will be implementing based on the different type of case studies there. So it is having total of 14 different domains. So I think I'm having one question. Hopefully my sound is clear to you, everyone there.
Yes.
Okay, so I think it is.
I can hear it clear.
Perfect.
Very okay.
Perfect. Thank you. So I think it is only you as you were. So just check. Yeah. So we have total of 14 different domains here, or you can say 14 different chapters here to discuss, which is completely intense, where we will discussing each of the components very minutely to check what are, how exactly the solutions will work. And definitely to let you understand properly, I will be giving you demonstration, or the trainers are actually going to provide you the demonstration with the help of some of the cloud, you know, platform there. Like suppose in front of your screen right now, I'm open with AWS console there. So in this AWS console, if you see carefully there, we are having different set of services: compute, storage, blockchain, management, governance, analytics, security, IoT, Internet of Things, and everything there. So when I'm talking about the encryption, so for the encryption, how exactly the encryption will work and what are the different best practices available for the implementation there. So this is what exactly we are going to discuss. So in the course content area, we are first going to start our discussion with cloud computing there, which is actually the basics. First, what exactly the cloud computing is, what is the definitions given there by the NIST and ISO. Definitely we are actually looking for the best practices available. So we have to also understand the different perspective of the different standards there, how exactly they are viewing, they are having a view over the cloud. And based on that, we are going to, you know, select a solution there. So we are first going to start our discussion with cloud computing concept and the architecture. So definitely here we are going to check how exactly the architectural components are connected together for the cloud there. Which component is actually going to be, you know, most core and important component there. And for that, CSA has also given some logical layer. So which layer is actually going to important and why? That one is actually going to discuss, and definitely who is responsible for that layer to manage. We will be starting our discussion with the provider and customer. Then within the provider, what are the different roles which is actually responsible for that particular solutions to implement it there. It will let you know how exactly these things will work on the cloud there. So if you are having any kind of trouble while utilizing the cloud, you know that who is responsible for that particular solution. And definitely based on that, you're having a very clear picture on the mind there while implementing the solution and the control there. After discussing the first chapter, which is actually on the cloud computing, then we are going to discuss how exactly the governance and enterprise risk management component will work on the cloud there. See, remember when I'm talking about the governance, governance is basically the rule which will help you to run the organization properly, which is actually includes policies, standards, guidelines, and, you know, the procedures. So when you are implementing the governance, these are the four different components you have, which is actually going to let you implement the things properly. One of the core components of governance is actually the compliance as well there, which will let you know the, whether the controls which I'm implementing is properly followed or not there. So in this chapter, we'll be discussing about the governance properly there. So for the software as a service, how, what are the different type of options we have there for the governance? For the infrastructure as a service, the same thing we are going to discuss here. Then finally, after that, we are going to discuss about the legal issues which can possible onto the cloud there, specifically data movement and the control implementation. How exactly the contracts needs to be created and what are some of the components of the contract which we have to focus very precisely there. Like when you go for the software as a service is one of the highly negotiated example of the contract. Why? Because if you are not able to negotiate properly while, you know, starting business with your provider in software as a service, later on, if there is any incident in the cloud and you require some evidence or some set of data there, you cannot get if it is not there in the contract. So soft, because most of the things is going to manage by the provider. So if it is not written, you will be not getting it there. It is totally on the goodwill of your provider. You know, they can provide or not there, but definitely from your side, you need to be very much strong as a customer. So contract is actually going to be a very important tool here. And then e-discovery. Whenever you're looking for evidences in the cloud, e-discovery tools are actually going to let you understand how exactly I will be doing the searching. You need to also understand that other customer data should not going to be impacted there. And definitely for that provider is responsible for. But if another customer is trying to do electronic discovery, you have to understand how exactly the provider is actually going to protect my data there while going for the e-discovery. And for that, what are the different set of solutions available there? Another chapter we have is actually on the compliance and audit management, where we are going to discuss about the compliance there. So what are the different compliance management things we have onto the cloud there? Like when I'm going for the cloud, there might be a possibility that you're looking for a payment gateway. So for the payment gateway, you need to compile with PCI DSS. Definitely you are not going to select a provider who is not PCI DSS compliant. And even in the PCI DSS, we have level 1, level 2, level 3, and level 4. So which level is actually going to suit your requirement? And what is the condition for that one? The same thing for the ISO 27000 certification as well there. Same thing for the NIST certification as well there. So in the compliance section, we will be discussing about which provider is compliant with what certification and how exactly we can check whether provider is compliant or not, and what are the relevant documentation we have to obtain from the provider to prove for that, but as a proof for that one. Sometimes we are working as a cloud service broker or cloud service customer. So for me also, there is a customer. So when I'm taking the data from the customer, I have to make sure that I'm letting them know with all the evidences that wherever I'm going to do their data processing, that site is totally secure. And for to make sure that I'm proving, definitely we need to have a proper audit management. So for the auditing, what are the different documentations available there? And how exactly we can start audit? And what are the different things we have to check while going for the audit? And what are some of the tools offered by the provider to let you, you know, provide you the data, what you're looking for, fastly and immediately there. So these are some of the things which you have to take care properly. And based on that, definitely based on that, you will be getting the data properly there. Another thing is the information governance. Information is very, very important there, specifically for the 21st century there. Information is the key things. Without information, we are not able to manage the data. But what about if I'm sending the data onto the cloud? And because in the cloud, the data is getting replicated fastly and swiftly, how can we manage the data properly? So for the information governance, what are some of the tools available there from the each of the provider side? And what are the best practices to manage the information there? That one too. Remember, layered security is actually one of the key things there. And definitely totally depends on the type of risk. You need to select the proper governance components there. So for the information governance, what are some of the tools available there? And what sort of tools is actually going to help you select, you know, that one too, we will be discussing about there. So these are the first five chapter we have. The sixth chapter, in the sixth chapter, we'll be discussing about the management. Now from here, so till now you can see more over towards the management. Now from here, the people who is actually from the technical background actually going to, you know, gave you very much interest there. Because from this section, the technical things from the cloud side is actually going to be started there. First thing we will be discussing about the management plane. You know, when you're going to access the cloud, you will be either accessing through the console or you are having the CLI option, or you are having the SDK, software development kits, or you are having the APIs there. So when I'm accessing cloud, to manage the cloud, we have the management plane. And for the management plane, what are the different sort of security you need to offer That one we will be discussing in this section there. Remember, if your management plane is not secured, your internal data, information, and the component for your organization is also not secure. So one of the first thing we have to start with the management plane security. We also have to take care of the business continuity there, because as we are progressing for the business benefit there, organization benefit, we have to also look for the worst part. There's some cases where we had seen that even I'm very much, you know, secure or configured with all of the solutions there, you know, some risk is always there after that. We need to understand whether the risk is acceptable or not, and if it is not, how exactly we can manage this. So business continuity, BCP, business continuity planning will let you know how exactly we need to manage the business continuity on through the cloud. Remember, in the cloud, we have one of the major benefit that we can replicate our data beyond the geographical area as well, because we have multiple options there. And clouds are also available in multiple availability zone there. So we need to understand how exactly this flexibility is actually getting there into the cloud. So business continuity planning and multiple reasons is what exactly we'll be discussing there. Then finally, we are going to start our discussion with infrastructure security, where we are discussing about the infrastructure part there. In infrastructure part, we will be discussing about what are the core components of the infrastructure in the cloud there. When I'm talking about the infrastructure security there, we have to understand that in the infrastructure, we have some component like virtual machine, virtual network, firewall, you know, multiple things we have there. So how exactly we can build the infrastructure, that is the first thing. And then when they are communicating with each other, where exactly the security loopholes can possible. And then based on from that particular part, we will be looking for the solutions which is offered by the provider. And if it is not, then can we integrate the third party security as a service provider? So we have here the concept of security as a service as well. Sorry, it is actually called as the SECaaS, SECaaS, security as a service. So how exactly it will implement? Now for the security as a service, we have a dedicated chapter also available there. So in the security as a service, what are the different options we have? Like, security as a service is actually going to offer you the IAM solution. They are going to offer you the encryption solution and multiple and many more there. So as a if I'm going for the management, there is a concept we are following that is called segregation of duty. So if I'm managing our data onto the cloud provider, I'm not going to utilize the encryption solution from there or controls from there. So I'm segregating them. In this way, I'm actually going to enhance the security there. One of the basic part we have for the cloud is actually the virtualization and container. So what is virtualization and what is containerization? That one too we will be discussing. Now that one is actually completely kind of, you can say, technical, but which one is best? Because when we are talking about the workload, we have the option of creation of VM. We have the option of creating the container. We have the option of using the serverless. So we'll be checking all of this particular one. Okay. For short frame sound degradation. So hopefully now, is the sound is degraded for you all guys? Am I audible to everyone properly?
You're fine for me.
Okay.
Hey, you're very clear, very wonderful.
Okay. Okay. Okay, great. Yeah. So in case of virtualization and containerization, we will be discussing about the different aspect, like what is the benefit of having VM, and then what is the demerits of the virtual machine as well. On top of that, if I'm creating the container, like what is the benefit of container and how exactly it will help you to run the workload securely. Remember, when we are talking about the workload, I'm actually talking about the unit of processing. So when I'm talking about the unit of processing, I am looking for a solution which is not only let me run my workload smoothly, but also at the same time provide me the security as well. So if I'm running very few services, definitely it will create a, you know, less option for the attack. And definitely that one is going to good for you there. So in that case, might be utilizing the container, you will be utilizing the serverless computing infrastructure or some functions as well there. So in this chapter in the virtualization security, we'll be discussing our first thing about the hypervisors, which is one of the core component of the virtualization and definitely for the cloud as well. And then after we'll be discussing about the containers and the workload there. So this chapter is dedicatedly on the workload for the processing. So which one is actually going to best and why? So that one too we will be discussing about. After that, we have a section on the incident response. So in case of incident response, we'll be discussing first about what is incident, and then after we'll be discussing about the response there. After that, we have the application security section. Different type of application based attack which can possible. So for the application based attack, what are the different type of controls given there? That one we will be discussing about. And finally, we are going to discuss data security and the encryption. So different sort of storage options we have in the cloud, like we have volume storage, we have object storage, we have, you know, a structured on a structured set of data as well. So what are the different controls given there for the, you know, protection? One of the major component for the protection is the identity part. So even that one too, we will be discussing in a separate section, and then we will see there what are the best practices available for the implementation. And then very importantly, we have the related technologies. You know, when you're talking about the cloud is actually going to best suits the big data, IoT, and artificial intelligence, these things. Why? Because of the different options which the provider is clouds are offering you, like broad network access, huge storage space, you know, multiple processing and the multiple processors, which is actually going to provide the high processing speeds there. So how exactly these technologies is getting benefited from the cloud? That one we'll discuss there. And what are the core components most of the provider is offering you to let the customer utilize and definitely to integrate with the business to get more and more benefit there. So over and all, CCSK is going to let you understand first thing, what are the solutions available, and then the issues. And then finally, we will be talking about the controls. When you understand this vendor neutral certification, when you complete this certification, definitely it will let you know about the different issues and control implementation, so you can secure your cloud infrastructure properly there. Apart from the topics which we had discussed in the previous slide, we have some more documentations to discuss in the same certification, like we have cloud control metrics, which is actually a document where we'll discussing about what are the best practices available there, not only for the customer, even for the auditor. This documentation is very, very much important. So they should know there what are some of the options we have. Apart from this, we will be also discussing about one more documentation that is called as the CAC, which is called as the Consensus Assessment Initiative Questionnaire. So Cloud Security Alliance has created a template. That template is very much aligned with CCM. So in this template, Cloud Security Alliance has created a set of questions, and the answers are actually provided by the cloud providers. Like Azure is having their own CAC document. AWS is actually having their own CAC documentation. Now you will see their response, and whichever response suits your requirement most, CAC documentation will help you select that provider very easily there. So we'll discuss how exactly CAC documentation will help you to select the best provider as per your need. One of the important thing without understanding the risk, we cannot select the control. And definitely, what are some of the control options we have? Even that one is also listed in the same documentation. It will help me most there. ENISA risk report is actually on the same side there. So this documentation also the part of the CCSK. We'll be discussing about the risk related to the cloud and then control for that. And you will be also getting the SECaaS documentation, security as a service documentation. Like if I'm implementing the IAM, for the IAM implementation, what is the best practices available there? If I'm implementing the encryption, for the encryption, what are the best practices available there? So these things has been discussed there in the SECaaS documentation. We will take one of the examples so it will let you understand how exactly you need to handle this documentation while implementing the solutions within your organization. So all in all, when you complete this section, you will be having all of the different understanding on the cloud security and the risk, which will help you understand the control implementation precisely. So this is what we have from this particular, you know, certification course. This is what I need to discuss. Now, let me just discuss one more slide and then after I will be taking your questions there. After completing the course, very much importantly, you will be also interested in taking the examination. As I told you that from the Coding Solution, we have the 100% passing rate there till now. So for the Certificate of Cloud Security Knowledge, we first thing you will be having a multiple choice question. So the examination is MCQ based, where you will be getting total of 60 questions, and out of you need to secure 80% to pass the examination. And the duration has been given there 1 hour and 30 minutes. So you can say in 90 minutes, you need to complete the examination and you need to secure the 80% to pass the examination out of 60 questions given there. When you purchase the CCSK examination, you will be getting 2 tokens. Unfortunately, if there is a case, if you're not able to pass the first attempt, immediately you can do the second attempt there for the examination. But it's my guarantee that after completing all of this section there, you know, first attempt is going to be enough for you to pass the examination very easily. So this is what I need to discuss about from this particular certification course there. Now I will be taking up your questions. If you have any questions, whatever I had discussed, feel free to ask. So I'm in the chat box as well. If you have any question, guys, please let me know there.
This course is across of all clouds, of Microsoft Cloud and Amazon Cloud and Google Cloud.
Yeah, as I told you,
it's not specially of one cloud.
Correct. So as I told you that it is actually a vendor neutral certification. So it is not going to focus on any of the vendor.
Okay.
So we'll be discussing about those component, which is actually common in all of the cloud platform there. Definitely each of the provider is having their own, you know, unique type of solutions available there, which is actually making them unique. But this course is not going to discuss on the same there. You know, one of the major things.
You need technical knowledge of all clouds?
Yes, we were discussing, you know, basically all. So definitely when I'm going to discuss any of the solution, that time I will be giving you the examples, like what are the solutions available there in the Azure, what are the solutions available in the AWS, and what are their core benefit there.
Okay.
Yeah.
Thanks.
Welcome. Guru Sharan is also having a question, how CISM, CISSP or CISA differ from CCSK? So if I'm coming to your question, Guru Sharan, then in that case, CISM is completely on the information security management, where you will be discussing on the governance side more and the security management there. So CISM is more over for the guy who's actually managing the security, information security. So CISM is not focusing on the cloud part there. When you go for the information security, then it is actually discussing about the various part of the security, which is having a very specific, you can say a very small component of the cloud there, But CISSP is focusing more on the complete information security side there. If you go for the CISA, which is actually for the auditor, information security auditor, where you will be having a very small portion on the cloud, but that is not that much of. But on the CCSK, we will be only discussing on the cloud, nothing more than the cloud there. Okay, CCSK is completely depend, completely only for the cloud there. We will be discussing on the cloud and the various aspect on the cloud there.
I understood,
Perfect.
So this basically, like, we are going to discuss basically in this course, general security guidelines for any cloud infrastructure, right?
Correct. So how exactly the controls has been given there? Each of the providers is now offering you a certain solution. So what solution, like in case of, if you're going for the cloud audit, security assessment in AWS, what is the tool available there? From the Azure side, what are the tools available there? And how exactly these are different? And which one is actually going to best? It means we are going to discuss best practice, and then we will see how much AWS is aligned to that best practice, how much Azure is aligned to the best practice, and how much Google is aligned to the best practice. This will help you to select the provider.
So like this is okay, this I understand. But my question is, like, we have a security associate, like engineer certification from the Azure also. So what is the difference there? Like, my question is, like, if I do this course, will I be able to do Azure certification? Azure Security Engineer certification is there, right?
Yes.
So correct. Like, will this course cover, give me enough knowledge that I can read on my own, if something is left, and then do it there also?
Okay. Now, let me give you very clear on that particular one. Thank you for asking that question. See, if you're going for the AWS security specialty, that is one of the certification available from the AWS. So AWS security specialty is only going to provide you the knowledge on the tools available there onto the AWS, nothing more than that. Okay. When you're going for the...
I think I understand your point. Like, basically you are saying, like, the knowledge that this course will give you is generic, that it will give you broader knowledge, like which tools for security you are going to use for the Azure or for AWS or for the Google Cloud. But my question is, like, after doing this course, if we do on our own, like we go for the, like, AWS certification or Azure certification for the cloud security, when we start going over it, it should be easy for us, right? Then we should be able to do it, right?
It will help you to do the AWS security or Azure security, you know, after that very easily, because now you are having a complete understanding and the perspective, like how exactly the best practices in the security world on the cloud will work there. Definitely it will help you. But it is not a replacement of these certifications, remember.
No, I understand your point.
Yeah. Okay, I think there is one more question we have from the Varun. Is CCSK on parallel with Comshare Cloud Plus? I cannot say that particular one, Varun, because in the CCSK, we are having various best practices discussed there, which is actually lacking in the Cloud Plus. Comshare is moreover focusing on from the technical side there. Okay, but CCSK is first, you know, 70% of the course curriculum is actually from the management side, and 30% is actually having more discussion on the, you know, technical side. Remember, there are two different view we have on the solution. First, what are the, you know, different control implementation we have and how exactly we can implement the control? And the second thing is, what are the best practices implementation options we have for that particular control? So best practice implementation is actually going to be the more main focus area of the CCSK there. And for that, it has discussed all of the different implementation and the case studies there. Hopefully you got the point and got the answer, Varun.